everyone, and welcome to another episode of Light the Wick. I'm your host, James Wheatman. This week, we headed downtown to check out one of Youngstown's well-known restaurants and got a chance to see just how hard the Irish party in Youngstown during St. Patrick's Day. But first, let's get started with another segment of Moments in Mahoning. The Covelli Center has been a part of our city's skyline for some time now, but we seem to forget the story behind it. It began with former Congressman Jim Traficant, who secured a redevelopment grant in 2000. Back then, it was referred to as the Youngstown Convocation Center. In 2005, the newly named Chevrolet Center opened its doors after a year of construction. Its first event featured the Three Doors Down. In 2009, the name officially changed to the Covelli Center after Chevrolet's contract expired. Over the past 10 years, the arena's life, the Covelli Center has hosted two hockey teams, arena football, WWE, and a wide array of concerts and shows. Big names include Elton John, Wiz Khalifa, and Carrie Underwood. After 10 years and two name changes, the Covelli Center stands as one of the area's most popular venues. It has brought entertainment to thousands of area residents. Now, as many of you know, this past Tuesday was St. Patrick's Day. Our very own Sydney Sims headed downtown to Federal Street to check out the festivities.
Hey, it's Sydney Sims, and I am here on Federal Street, and it is St. Patrick's Day. I am outside the pub O'Donnell's. As you can see behind me, a lot is going on, and we are going to get down to the bottom of it here, right on Light the Wick. What brought you out to Federal Street? Out of the restaurants, you chose to come to O'Donnell's on Federal Street. Why?
Downtown Youngstown is really, I think, starting to make a revival. It's starting to come back. It's really nice down here. You don't have anything to worry about. The clubs are clean and nice, and it's a fun night out.
I'm loving the outfit right now. What, like, made you throw this all together? You just
went to party place, found some stuff, put it together, I'm like, good to go.
Tell me, how is the environment and the energy just going on right now?
Everything's awesome. Everything's great. Everybody's just in a lively, happy mood. People are drinking, having a good time. It's great.
All right. While roaming Federal, I was lucky enough to talk to a manager of one of the bars.
Okay, tell me about what specials that you have running on right now for St. Patrick's Day.
Okay, well, we do have a limited menu today, not our normal big menu, but of course we're doing the Reubens and all that kind of stuff. We have our brand new hot dog cart that we got today.
I love it.
So we're doing brats and hot dogs out here. Inside, lots of drink specials, jello shots, lots of giveaways, that kind of stuff. Appetizers have been reduced in price. So, you know, people can try some of our appetizers, and then late night, we have entertainment all night, pretty much.
I was curious to find out the number one spot on Federal Street for St. Patrick's Day.
So tell me, since I'm a YSU student, tell me where is the number one place to go right now on St. Patrick's Day? Since you guys are here and have already experienced it, where should I go?
O'Donnell's and Martini Brothers and Vernon's.
You gotta go to those three. They're tied.
Okay. Vernon's Cafe has a shuttle going from the restaurant to downtown here, so it drives you back and forth.
Nice. Okay, so V2, Martini Brothers, and O'Donnell's. Those are the three places to go. You guys heard that right here.
This is Sydney Sims with Light the Wick.
Well, I'll tell you what, it looked like everyone had a wonderful time. Now, Project Hollywood is an area initiative to build the infrastructure needed to support the growing film industry in the Youngstown region. The project will work to bring economic impact to the area as well as employment opportunities for residents. It will reach far and wide to benefit our community by directly creating and promoting a healthy, vibrant environment. We had a chance to talk to the director, Fred D'Amico, about exactly what Youngstown Hollywood is.
Project Young Hollywood was a name I had come up with based on, I had a proposal, an idea that we need to build a film infrastructure. And this is a project. So I called it Project Young Hollywood. We're a young Hollywood about to happen, but we're also Youngstown Hollywood. And it made so much sense because Youngstown and Hollywood have such a tie between the names that we already know that are in Hollywood that have
Warner
been out
Brothers.
There. Warner Brothers started here. We obviously have Ed O'Neill that's out there as well and others.
They're looking for volunteers for talent and crew positions. For more information on this and more, head to their website listed on the screen. This week in Food on Federal, we visit a hidden downtown gem.
This is James Naples reporting for YSU's Light the Wick. This week on Food on Federal, we're highlighting Roberto's restaurant down here on the corner of Phelps and Federal Plaza. Let's go in and take a look at Roberto's.
As you enter Roberto's, there is a lovely intimate bar area that leads to a cozy dining area with an old world feel. As we journey downstairs, it's as if we have stepped back in time to an old world Italy. With seating for parties up to 40, Roberto's is a pleasant surprise in the blossoming downtown area. The ambiance is such that once you sit down, you feel as if you're at home. With a lunch and dinner menu that is sure to please, including their signature finocchi dish, we sat down with the chef, and here's what he had to say.
We're sitting here with Roberto down here on Federal Plaza. Roberto, how long have you been in business here?
February was 3 years.
Now, I've noticed that you have a nice lunch menu. What time does your lunch menu run?
The lunch goes Tuesday through Friday, 11 to 4.
And then what time are you usually open till?
Tuesdays during the winter months, we're open till 8. Wednesday, Thursday till 9, and then Friday and Saturday till 10. And Saturdays, we don't open till 5.
How long have you been cooking?
Oh my gosh, my whole life. But everything I've learned from my grandparents and my mother. Just growing up, I'd have a little stool next to them and watch and learn. And so all my whole life, you know.
Now, are most of your dishes that you make here, are those family recipes?
They're all family recipes, yes. It's the more of the traditional Italian food from southern Italy. Like the fiocchi is real famous in the Rome area. Which is a little pasta purse filled with four cheeses and pear, which is a very big hit here. Then we do all the fishes during the holidays. We do some things on the menu that most other places don't, like we do squangili, which is the conch fish cooked in sauce over linguine. We do the baccala, a lot of traditional Italian dishes.
Roberto, it's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
And continued success here.
Thank you.
That was this week's Food on Federal. A thanks to Roberto's for letting us stop by. If you have anything that you would like us to cover, make sure you email us at ysulightthewick@gmail.com or message us on our Facebook or Twitter. We leave you with a performance from the Butler Institute of American Arts, Music at Noon. We see you next week here on Light the Wick.